Aaliyah would be 41, 42 years old right now. She was born 1979, and she died in 2001. But to get to her story, she grew up very attractive, very pretty. She made good grades in school. She went to middle school, high school. She was well loved, popular, outgoing, outspoken. She went to Detroit Performing Arts School. You know, I heard she excelled. She became a singer. She did movies. She did Romeo Must Die, which was very good, a Jet Li movie. I've seen that movie so many times over the past 20 years. I've seen that movie probably over 40 times. That's a very, very entertaining movie. Very good movie. Yeah, I kind of wish there was a sequel to it. She did a sequel with him, with the guy Jet Li, the Asian guy. That was a very good movie. She started dating R. Kelly, rumors that they were dating, and it was weird because he was in his late 20s. And why would a 27-year-old guy want to be with a girl that's 15? She can't relate to him. He has life experience. I think he was divorced, or he had girlfriend. He was sexually experienced. And so a lot of people thought he was weird, but him being illiterate and he doesn't have the mindset of an adult. His mind is like a child. He thinks like a teenager. He thinks like a child. He doesn't think like an adult. You know, this is why he was always dating teenage girls. You know, he was always messing around teenage girls. It's because I think his mind is more, he can't relate to a woman that's professional, that a woman his own age. He only could relate to girls that were younger than him. Or it was kind of weird sickness for him. But he was very weird. Like I said, he's a good artist. But anyway, she dated him. They got married at 15. Ew. I mean, she was only in the ninth or tenth grade when she got married. You know, that's too young. You know, it didn't last but a couple weeks. But they got divorced. And she moved on with her life. And she was, you know, like I said, she was very attractive, very thin, very, very skinny. She did Queen of the Damned, which is a very good movie. That was one of her last movies. She was supposed to do the Matrix movies. But she was supposed to do the Matrix 2 and 3. But she died, you know. The airplane, she was on an aircraft, which was a very small airplane. The reason that the plane crashed was because there was too much luggage on it. I think they told her that it was too much luggage, that the airplane is too small, they can't fit all that luggage on. But she was a rich, spoiled girl, multimillionaire. She wanted to have it her way. So they put all the luggage, they took a risk, and they put all the luggage on the airplane. And they were flying, you know, and it crashed. And the reason it crashed was because there was too much luggage on it. Aaliyah and about 8 other people died, including the hairdresser. It's very sad that these people, they were going, you know, she did a music video. And then she was coming back home, and then the point that happened. She was good friends with Missy Elliott. Lisa Lopez had a nervous breakdown. Lisa Lopez died about a year later. And I think it's because of her missing Aaliyah. It's very sad, you know. I think she would have been very good. She probably would have did Matrix 2 and 3. She would be probably done a lot of TV shows. She probably done a lot of concerts, awards. She probably did a lot of movies, and she would have probably changed the whole world. I think the world probably been a lot more different if she was here, because she was already becoming famous. She was supposed to do the Matrix 2 and 3, but it never happened because of her death. She died at a very young age. She was only 22 years old. She was 22, young, fresh, very a college girl. You know, just so, you know, so young. You know, and very sweet and kind-hearted. She was also in a relationship with Jay-Z. Well, Jay-Z had a crush on her, but she kept rejecting Jay-Z. Jay-Z wanted to date her, but he couldn't get her. But anyway, Mr. J here, peace.